Leicester Square has gone a little bit crazy for my three guests. Margot, Brad and Leo, thank you for joining me. And can I say huge congratulations on this film. It is awesome. It's so great.
Thank you so much.
Margot, I'm going to start with you. In terms of Sharon Tate, for me, she feels like the kind of light and optimism in terms of if she's a kind of theme around this film. For you, when you were approached and asked to play her, where did you start with her?
It was very clear in the way that Quentin had written her that she really was more of a presence throughout the film and very much to bring, like you said, that hope, that optimism, the light, kind of show the wonderful parts of Hollywood in 1969.
And for you, sir, I think that one thing that people forget about Mr. Tarantino is he's an extraordinary director, but he's also an exceptional writer. And I wanted to ask what your response was when you first read the script and what it was that tipped you over to say yes to play Quentin.
First of all, when Tarantino calls, everyone says yes, no question.
Okay.
But on the immediate read, it's pretty,
oh my God,
it's so specific, his writing, it's pretty evident, but
you're amazing.
The tone of the film.
Yeah.
So it's automatic. He makes it really easy for us.
And Leo, for you, in terms of this character, there's so many layers to him, there's so many parts that you have to play as an actor. It's a film within a film, it's all that kind of stuff. Does he encourage you to kind of bring as much of it yourself to the table as what's on the script?
I would say a combination of both. The amazing thing about getting to work with Quentin is all the reference that he gives you, not only from his own, from history, from his own imagination, but actually getting to watch films. I mean, it's truly an educational process. He's one of the most unique visionary filmmakers of our time, and his ability to combine, you know, fairy tales with reality is nobody else does it like him. So the whole process of creating these characters and all that reference is what makes the film ultimately an incredibly enjoyable experience.
Even the singing?
I'm still cannot hold it to this
day. I think you did pretty well. You know, fun. I'd give you 7 out of 10.
They tried several songs and apparently
did
that was the song he sound best.
Best at best.
What was it like on a, how would you describe being on set of a Quentin Tarantino film? Because I've spoken to producers, some of your other castmates here as well tonight, and it feels like such a kind of family environment in terms of all teamwork. Is that how you would describe it?
It is. I mean, so many of the crew members that you work with on the set have worked with Quentin since, you know, Marty's worked with him since Reservoir Dogs. So, I mean, there really is a community and family feel there, and they all have in-jokes. And then anyone welcomed to that family for the first time is immediately, you know, feels a part of it. It's fun, and he always plays music. And
on the set?
Yeah. So it was just a lot of fun. Yeah.
Does anyone else get to pick the music, or is it just Quentin that gets to choose the music?
There's no need to step in.
He's a good DJ.
He's
pretty
good at it.
Yeah.
What was your reaction when you saw the film finished for the first time?
I mean, pleased as punch. You know, Tarantino always brings something fresh and something new and very unique. And what I most love about this one that I didn't understand during shooting, it really feels like a confluence of all his work. There's a little bit of all his previous work in this, and it's threaded really beautifully.
Yeah. And Leo, in terms of for you for this character, what was the preparation that you did? I believe that you kind of stepped into the world of a particular TV star that Quentin was a big fan of.
Yeah, as Brad was saying, it's really an homage or a love story to the industry. And, you know, Brad and I in this film play characters that are sort of voyeuristic. The culture has left us behind, the industry has left us behind, and we're watching the changing of the guard, so to speak. So It was interesting to not only to step into this time period, but to play two guys that are sort of on the outskirts, trying to still survive within a
the industry that they love. But it really is a love letter to Hollywood and Los Angeles.
And how much they need each other, that friendship, that kind of camaraderie between each other. And for, you know, for people whose careers have gone through a number of years in Hollywood, you find those friendships that you stick with as well. Nice thing to celebrate. We've run out of time. Thank you so much for coming and joining us here. Please, everybody, put your hands together for Margot Robbie, Brad Pitt.
Thanks for coming out. We appreciate it.